Hello friends, welcome to TalentSprint. I hope all of you are doing well and preparing well for your upcoming exams. So I would like to apologize because we got delayed by 15 days to publish this December month current affairs. So today in our presentation, we have around 125 questions. I'll represent all the questions one by one. So here is the first question on your screens.
Which country has taken over the presidency of G20? And the answer here is, it's Saudi Arabia. So the G20 presidency has been taken by Saudi Arabia from Japan, and Saudi Arabia has become the first Arab nation to assume G20 presidency. So what is this G20? So this is an international forum for the governments and central bank governors from 19 countries and the European Union. And this was founded in the year 1999. Who has assumed charge as the 27th new Comptroller General of Accounts? And the answer here is Suma Roy Burman. And she has replaced JPS Chawla. And she became the 7th woman to hold this position. And prior to this, she has served as the additional Comptroller General of Accounts in the office of CGA. Who has won the Abu Dhabi Grand Prix held at Abu Dhabi of UAE? And the answer here is, this has been won by Lewis Hamilton. And he is the Mercedes racer, whereas Max Verstappen of Red Bull finished at second position. The Global Migration Film Festival was organized in Dallas, and it was organized in Dhaka. So this festival screened around 15 films on the theme of migration and its various aspects, and the festival was organized by the International Organization of Migrants and Dhaka University of Film Society. And who is the chief of International Organization of Migrants? That is International. Organization of Migrants, that is IOM. So who is the chief of this IOM? It's Georgi Gyori. And it was established in the year 1951. Who took over as the 14th Commander-in-Chief of the Andaman and Nicobar Command? And the answer here is, it's General Podali Sankar Rajeshwar. Now the next question, who has taken over as the charge as Chairman of Ordnance Factory Board? And the answer here is, this has been taken by Hari Mohan. And he is going to replace Saurabh Kumar. So the Ordnance Factory Board founded in the year 1712 and headquarters is located in West Bengal of Kolkata. And the headquarters is located in Kolkata of West Bengal. Now the next question. Who has won the 12th Sakti Bhatt First Book Prize? And the answer here is, this has been won by Tony Joseph. And he was awarded for his book written in 2018, that is Early Indians, the story of our ancestors and where we came from. Now the next question. Who claimed the gold medals in 55 kg category at the Senior Wrestling National Championship in Jalandhar of Punjab? And the answer here is, it is claimed by Vinesh Pogat. So Vinesh Pogat here has claimed the gold in 55 kg category, whereas Sakshi Malik here, she has claimed gold in 62 kg category. Who has elected as the new president of Mauritius? And the answer here is Prithviraj Singh Ropun. Right, so Prithviraj Singh Ropun has been elected as the president of Mauritius, and he was the former art and culture minister of Mauritius. And who is the prime minister of Mauritius is Pravind Kumar Jugnauth. Now the next question, the Asian Development Bank board has unanimously elected Dash as its new president after Takehiko Nakago. And the answer here is Matsutsugu Asakawa. And he will be succeeding Takehiko Nakago, who will leave the office on January of 2020. So this Asian Development Bank was established in the year 1966. And this is owned by 68 member countries. The Asian Development Bank has agreed to advance a loan of Dash to develop the water supply and sewerage infrastructure in Tamil Nadu. And the answer here is 206 US million dollars. And this project will target the cities namely Ambur, Tiruchirappalli, Tirupur and Vellore of Tamil Nadu for developing the sewage collections and treatment and drainage systems. Now the next question, the Walmart India in partnership with Dash launched a co-branded credit card offering free credit up to 50 days. And the answer here is it's HDFC. Where is the headquarter of Walmart? It is in Gurgaon. And who is the president CEO of Walmart? It's Krish Iyer. And where is the headquarter of HDFC? It is in Mumbai, right? And who is the chairman? It's Deepak Parekh. Who has won the Ballon d'Or award for the world's best player? And the answer here is, it's Lionel Messi. So he belongs to Barcelona and he has won the world's best player for the record 6th time. This is the 6th time he has won this award. Now the next question, the government has launched the 4th round of regional connectivity scheme, that is UDAN, to further enhance the connectivity to remote and regional areas of the country. So what does A stands for in UDAN? And the answer here is A stands for AAM. So what does this UDAN stands for? UDE DESH KA AAM NAGRIK. So this is the full form of UDAN, so A stands for AAM. And the focus will be in this round will be the northeastern region, hilly states and Jammu and Kashmir. Now the next question, the International Finance Corporation, a unit of World Bank Group, has approved an investment of Dash in Mahindra and Mahindra Financial Services Limited. And the answer here is, it's $200 million. So this International Finance Corporation, that is IFC, investing around $75 million from its own account and mobilizing another $125 million as a parallel loan. So when did this form? This formed in the year 1956 and headquarters is located in Washington, D.C. And there are around 184 member countries. Who was best over with the Economic Times Lifetime Achievement Award for the Public Service 2019? And the answer here is, it's Arun Jaitley. This has been given posthumously. So on behalf of Arun Jaitley, his spouse has collected this award. Now the next question, who among the following Hollywood actor has been bestowed with the PETA, that is People for the Ethical Treatment of Animals, Person of the Year Award 2019? And the answer here is Joaquin Rafael Phoenix. And he is the American actor who acted in the Joker movie. Now the next question. Which team has been awarded the Christopher Martin's Jenkins Spirit of Cricket Award? And the answer here is, this has been awarded to New Zealand. Now the next question. The National Investment and Infrastructure Fund of India and Canada Pension Plan Investment Board have agreed to invest up to dash through the NIIF Master Fund. And the answer here is, they are agreed to fund $600 million. And this agreement includes a commitment of $150 million in the National Investment and Infrastructure Fund of India, that is NIIF. Who is the MD and CEO of NIIF? It's Sujay Bose. Now the next question. The online trucking platform BlackBuck has partnered with the private lenders Dash and Dash to provide fast tags to truck owners free of cost. And the answer here is, it's IDFC Bank and Yes Bank. Who is the MD and CEO of IDFC Bank? It's V. Vaidyanathan. And what is the tagline for this bank? Always you first. This is the tagline of this bank. And who is the MD and CEO of Yes Bank? It's Ravneet Gill. And what is the tagline? Experience or expertise. This is the tagline of Yes Bank. Now the next question. So which general insurance company has launched My Health Woman Suraksha Policy, a comprehensive medical insurance scheme specially designed for women? And the answer here is, this has been launched by HDFC Ergo. And this policy is specially designed to cover the women against numerous illness so they may face during their lifetime, so thereby providing a financial aid in case of medical contingency. And this policy is offered to women between 18 to 65 years of age. And this will insure an amount of 1 lakh to 1 crore. And where is the headquarter of this HDFC Ergo? This is in Mumbai. And who is the MD and CEO? It's Ritesh Kumar. And it was established in the year 2002. Investors Education and Protection Fund Authority works under Ministry of Corporate Affairs has signed a memorandum of understanding with DAS to spread the customer awareness and investment education by reaching out to investors and stakeholders. And the answer here is, it has been signed memorandum of understanding with Bank of Baroda. So where is the headquarter of Bank of Baroda located? It is in Vadodara of Gujarat. And tagline is India's International Bank. Now the next question here. India and DAS ties a transcend strategic partnership to cover the traditional areas as well as IT, space and nuclear science. And the answer here is, India has tied up with Bangladesh. So what's the capital of Bangladesh? It's Dhaka. Currency is Taka. Now the next question. Who has been appointed as the senior security advisor in Union Home Minister? And the answer here is, it's K. Vijay Kumar. Now the next question. World AIDS Day is observed on DAS every year. And the answer here is, it is observed every year on 1st of December. And what was the theme of this year? The communities make the difference. Now the next question. The International Day for Abolition of Slavery observed every year on DAS, and it is observed every year on 2nd of December. Now the next question. The International Day of Persons with Disability is being observed on the DAS every year, and it is observed every year on 3rd of December. And what was the theme of this year? It is promoting the participation of persons with disability and the leadership, taking action on the 2030 development agenda. Now the next question. The Indian Navy Day is being celebrated in India on DAS, and it is being celebrated in India on 4th of December. And who is the Chief of Naval Staff? It's Admiral Karambir Singh. Now the next question. The International Volunteer Day is observed across the world on DAS every year, and it is observed across the world on 5th of December. And what is the theme of this year? This year's theme was Volunteer for an Inclusive Future. Now the next question. The Soil Day is celebrated across the world on DAS, aims to raise the awareness of importance of sustaining healthy ecosystem and human well-being. And the answer here is, this has been celebrated on 5th of December. And what was the campaign for this? Stop soil erosion and save our future. Now the next question. Armed Force Flag Day is observed on DAS every year across the country to honor the martyrs and armed forces personnel. And the answer here is, this has been observed on 7th of December. Now the next question. The United Nations General Assembly officially recognized DAS as an International Civil Aviation Day. And the answer here is, it's on 7th of December. So what was the theme of this year? The Civil Aviation Day is 75 years of connecting the world. So this was the theme of this year.
Who has been elected as the Prime Minister of Finland? And the answer here is Sanna Marin. And she is the youngest ever Prime Minister, just 34 years old. And what's the capital of Finland? It's Helsinki. And currency is Euro. Now the next question. The 8th edition of Embassy's annual film festival titled Ambassador's Choice Screening of Films was inaugurated at DAS. And it was inaugurated in Riyadh. So Riyadh is the capital of Saudi Arabia. And what's the currency of Saudi Arabia? It's Saudi Riyal. And this film festival was inaugurated at the auditorium of Embassies of India, Riyadh. And in this festival, they screened the popular Hindi film Dangal. Now the next question. The Human Library Event, a concept which seeks to replace the books with human, will be held in DAS. And it is going to be held in Mysore. So Mysore is in Karnataka. So what's the capital of Karnataka? It's Bangalore. And who is the Chief Minister? It's B.S. Yediyurappa. And Governor is Vajubhai Valla. And the notion of this human library was initially launched in the year 2000. And currently around 85 countries are part of it, and it is known as the Human Library Organization. Human Library Organization. And where is the headquarters of it? It is located in Copenhagen of Denmark. Who appointed as the National Stock Exchange of India Limited new chairman? And the answer here is, it's Girish Chandra Chaturvedi. And he is a retired IAS officer and former secretary of Ministry of Petroleum and Natural Gas. And currently he is a Board of ICICI Bank and a member of Government Appointed Board of Infrastructure Leasing and Financial Services Limited, that is ILNFS. What does this stands for? It's Infrastructure Leasing and Financial Services Limited. Now the next question. Who crowned Miss Universe 2019 in Atlanta, beating over 90 contestants from around the globe in the 68th installment of Miss Universe? And the answer here is, this has been won by Jojibini Tunji and she belongs to South Africa. So Miss South Africa Jojibini Tunji has crowned this Miss Universe 2019. So what's the capital of South Africa? There are three capitals. One is Cape Town, the second one is Pretoria, and the third one is Bloemfontein. Now the next question. DAS will train around 50,000 entrepreneurs from the micro, small and medium enterprises sector with an objective of fulfilling 25 institute hubs in India in another 5 years. And the answer here is Walmart. So Walmart will train around 50,000 entrepreneurs under Walmart Vriddhi Supplier Development Program. So what is that program name? It's Walmart Vriddhi Supplier Development Program. Now the next question. Which bank has provided $500 million line of credit to Bangladesh for defense related procurement in the neighboring countries? And the answer here is, it has been given by Exim Bank, that is Export Import Bank. So when it was founded? It was founded in the year 1982. Headquarters is located in Mumbai. And who is the CEO? It's David Raskina. Right? Now the next question. The News Broadcaster Federation has elected DAS as the president of its governing body. And the answer here is, it's Arnav Goswami. So who is Arnav Goswami? He is the editor-in-chief of Republic TV and he has been appointed as the president of News Broadcasters Federation. So what is this NBF? This is country's largest association over around 78 news channels. And in 14 languages. And it is covering around 25 states. Now the next question. Who among the following has not been awarded with 2019 Diwali Power of One Award in recognition and celebration of their work for a secure and peaceful world? And the answer here is, except Raul Castro, the other given option has been awarded with this award. And the first option is given, he is the former foreign ministry and permanent representative of Kazakhstan to UN. And the fourth option is given, Nicolas Emilio, he is the former permanent representative of Cyprus to the United Nations. And the fifth option is given, is František, and he is the president of 72nd session of United Nations General Assembly. And the second option is given, he is the permanent representative of Ukraine to the United Nations. So this four person has been awarded with this Diwali Power of One Award recognition. Now the next question, DAS has been selected as the world's leading sports tourism destination at the 26th edition of the World Travel Awards. And the answer here is Abu Dhabi. So this was being held in Muscat of Oman and this is the seventh time in a row that Abu Dhabi has been selected for this coveted award. Abu Dhabi is the capital of UAE and what is the currency of UAE? Dirham. And who is the president? Khalifa bin Zayed Al Nahyan. Now the next question, the World Anti-Doping Agency banned which country for 4 years from participation in global sporting events? And the answer here is, it's Russia. So after accusing the Moscow of falsifying the data from an anti-doping laboratory, the Russia has been banned. Even the Russian flag and the national anthem of Russia have also been banned in global events. So what does this WADA stands for? That is World Anti-Doping Agency, and it was established in the year 1999. And who is the president of WADA? It's Sir Craig Reddy. He's the president of WADA. And where is the headquarter located? It is located in Montreal of Canada. Who has been conferred with the Lifetime Achievement Award by the Consumer of Electronics and Appliance Manufacturer Association? And the answer here is, it's Gulu Mitchandani. And he is the founder and chairman of Mirk Electronics Limited, that is Onida. Now the next question, who has received the 2019 Nobel Peace Prize for his efforts to achieve the international peace and the cooperation? And the answer here is, this has been achieved by Abiy Ahmed. And he is the president of Ethiopia. What's the capital of Ethiopia? It's Addis Ababa. And currency is Ethiopian birr. Now the next question here. Who has been appointed as the next High Commissioner of India to the Republic of Ghana? And the answer here is, it's C. Sugandh Rajaram. So he is going to replace Birendra Singh Yadav. Now the next question. India has been ranked as among 189 countries in the Human Development Index 2019 released by the United Nations Development Programme. And the answer here is, India stood at 129th position. So last year India was on 130th position, and in this Human Development Index, Norway, Switzerland and Ireland, they have occupied the top three position, that is first, second and third position respectively. Now the next question. Who has won the fight open category of the London Chess Classic held in London? And the answer here is, it's R. Pragananda. Now the next question. Who has been selected as the brand ambassador of the National Anti-Doping Agency, NADA? And the answer here is, it's Sunil Shetty. Now the next question. The 13th South Asian Games concluded in Nepal, topped by which country? And it is topped by India. So India has finished the top position with 312 medals. Out of these, 174 are gold, 93 are silver and 45 are bronze. And it was held in Nepal. And who is the Prime Minister of Nepal? It's KP Oli Sharma. And capital is Kathmandu. And who is the President? It's Vidya Devi Bhandari. Now the next question. The International Mountain Day is held every year on DAS to encourage the sustainable development in mountains globally. And the answer here is, it is observed on 11th of December. And what was the theme of this year? Mountains matter for youth. This is the theme of this year. Now the next question. Who was honored at the Marrakech Film Festival held at the famous Jemaa Fena Square? And the answer here is, it's Priyanka Chopra. And she was honored for her 20 years of work and contribution in cinema. United Nations observed International Day of Neutrality on DAS each year. And the answer here is, it is observed each year on 12th of December. Now the next question, the International Universal Health Coverage Day is celebrated globally on DAS to raise the awareness of the need for strong and resilient health system. And the answer here is, it is observed on 12th of December. And what is the theme for this year? Keep the promise. Now the next question, Puma signed DAS as a brand ambassador. And the answer here is, it's Sunil Chhetri. So he is the Indian men's football team captain and he has signed a 3-year deal with Puma. Now the next question, PepsiCo appoints Dash as a Pepsi's brand ambassador. And the answer here is, it's Salman Khan. Dash has been named the Times Magazine's Person of the Year for 2019. And the answer here is, it's Greta Thunberg. And she's the youngest person to be chosen by the magazine in a tradition that started around 1927. And apart from her, here the third option is given Melissa Jefferson. And she has been awarded Entertainer of the Year award. And the first option is given Bob Iger, and he has been awarded Business Person of the Year. Now the next question, who become the world's 100 most powerful women in the Forbes 2019 list? And the answer here is, it's Angela Merkel. And she is at the first position. That means she has topped the list, whereas India's Nirmala Sitaram, she is on 34th position. And Sheikh Hasina, the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, she is on 29th position. And Christian Lagarde, she is at the second position. And Nancy Pelosi, she is at the third position. Who become the brand ambassador of La Liga in India? And the answer here is, it's Rohit Sharma. So what is this La Liga? This is the men's top professional football division of the Spanish football league system. And Rohit Sharma is the first non-footballer in last 90 years old history to become the brand ambassador of this league. So Rohit Sharma is the first non-footballer in the last 90 years old of history to become the brand ambassador for this league. Now the next question. India celebrates the National Energy Conservation Day every year on DAS to recognize and celebrate the efforts towards the energy conservation. And the answer here is, it's 14th of December. Now the next question, who elected as the president of Algeria? And the answer here is, it's Abdelmajid Tebboune. And what is the capital of Algeria? It's Algeria. And currency is dinar. Now the next question, who crowned as the winner of the Miss World 2019 beauty pageant held at the Excel of London? And the answer here is, it's Tony Ann Singh. So she belongs to Jamaica. And here the third option is given Ophelia Maginot of France. Is the first runner-up. Whereas Suman Rao from India, she is the second runner-up. Now the next question. India celebrates Dash as a Vijay Diwas to commemorate India's victory over Pakistan in 1971 war. And the answer here is, it's 16th of December. Now the next question. The International Day of Commemoration and Dignity of the Victims of the Crime of Genocides and of the Prevention of this Crime observed on DAS. And it is observed on 9th of December. And what is the purpose of this day? This day is observed to raise the awareness of the Genocide Convention and its role in combating and preventing the crime of genocides. So this 9th December is the anniversary of adoption of 1948 Convention on the Prevention and Punishment of this Crime of Genocides. And this year have completed 70th anniversary. Now the next question, the United Nations International Anti-Corruption Day has been observed annually DAS, and it is observed on 9th of December. And the day aims to raise the public awareness of corruption and what people can do to fight it, and what was the theme of it, United Against Corruption. This is the theme of this year. Now the next question. The Human Rights Day is observed every year on DAS, and it is observed every year on 10th of December. And this year is the 71st anniversary. And what was the theme of this year? Youth standing up for human rights. This is the theme of this year. Now the next question. Who among the following was the cricketer who passed away recently? And the answer here is Bob Willis. And if you look at the other option, the first option is given Bhaskar Menon. He's a veteran journalist who passed away recently. And the second option is given Sally Morrison. She's a Hollywood actress who passed away recently. The fourth option is given Paul Volcker. He is a former US Federal Reserve chief who passed away recently. And the fifth option is given Gulapudi Maruti Rao. He is a veteran Telugu actor and writer who also passed away. On which day the International Migrants Day is organized across the world to protect the rights of migrant workers and members of their families? And the answer here is, it's 18th of December. So it is celebrated to protect the rights of migrant workers and members of their family, and the theme for this year was We Together. Now the next question. Dash, a veteran actor who played an important role in the growth of theatre movement in Maharashtra, passed away recently. And the answer here is, it's Sriram Lagu. And if you look at the other option, here the second option is given L.S. Sesagiri Rao. He's a Kannada writer and critics who passed away recently. And the third option is given Thomas Chandy. He was the former Kerala minister who passed away recently. Now the next option is given I.D. Swami. He's the former Union Minister of State for Home Affairs in 1999 who passed away recently. And the last option is given Siddharth Kak, who is a Bollywood actress who passed away. Who has been awarded with BBC Sports Personality of the Year 2019? And the answer here is, this has been awarded to Ben Stokes. And he belongs to which team? He belongs to England. The Government of India and the Asian Development Bank has signed a DAS loan for energy efficiency investment in India. And the answer here is, it's $250 million. And this loan aims to expand the energy efficiency investment in India that will benefit the agricultural, residential and industrial consumers. And additionally, another $46 million financing will be provided from the Clean Technology Fund, that is CTF. CTF is going to provide another $46 million. And the project is expected to contribute the mission of the Government of India to promote the energy efficiency and to meet the government's commitment to reduce the energy intensity of the economy. Now the next question, who among the following has been appointed as the chairman cum managing director of National Aluminium Company Limited? And the answer here is, it's Sudhir Patra. So Nalco is a Navratna company and it is founded in the year 1981. Where is the headquarter? Headquarter is located in Bhubaneswar of Orissa. The State Bank of India has signed a loan agreement worth of DAS with the KFW, that is German Development Bank, for establishing an energy efficient housing program in India. And the answer here is, it's $277 million. And it is around 1958 crore. And who is the chairperson of SBI? Rajnish Kumar. Where is the headquarter located? It is in Mumbai and it was founded in the year 1955. Which private sector bank has become the third Indian firm to cross $1 billion mark in market capitalization? And the answer here is, it's HDFC Bank. So among the world's most valued banks and financial companies which have a market cap of over $100 billion, the HDFC Bank is ranked 26th position. Who is the managing director of HDFC? It's Aditya Puri. Where is the headquarter? It is located in Mumbai of Maharashtra. Now the next question. The Goods and Service Tax or GST Council has fixed a uniform tax rate of DAS on both state-run and private lottery. And the answer here is, it's 28%. And this GST charges has been implemented in the country since 1st July of 2017. Now the next question, how much concession will be Indian Railways offer to the youth participating in the Ek Bharat Shrestha Bharat program? And the answer here is, it's 50%. Who is our railway minister? It's Piyush Goyal. And this concession will be given in the base fare of second and sleepers class to the youth with an emolument of not more than 5,000 rupees per month for travelling from one state to other state to take part in this program. Now the next question. India and DAS have signed an agreement to facilitate the transfer of defense technology during 2+2 dialogue held in Washington of DC. And the answer here is, it's USA. Who is the Ministry of Defense? It's Rajnath Singh. And who is the Ministry of External Affairs? It's Subramaniam Jaishankar. Now the next question. Social Justice and Empowerment Minister has launched the Braille version of the book DAS written by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi. And the answer here is, it's Exam Warriors. So the Braille version in English and Hindi has been printed by the Rajasthan Netrahin Kalyan Sangh in Jaipur. And who is the Social Justice and Empowerment Minister? Is Thavarchand Gehlot. And here is the next question. Who among the following has been appointed as the Managing Director of the General Insurance Corporation of India? And the answer here is, it's Devesh Srivastav. When this founded, GIC, that is General Insurance Corporation of India, this was founded in the year 1972 and headquarters is in Mumbai. Now the next question here, the Asian Development Bank and the Government of India has signed a DAS loan to upgrade the roads of Madhya Pradesh. And the answer here is, it's $250 million. And the loan is signed for the public-private partnership project through the hybrid annuity model to upgrade about 1600 km of state highways and major district roads in the state of Madhya Pradesh. So where is the headquarter of Asian Development Bank? It is in Manila of Philippines. The International Human Solidarity Day is organized across the world on DAS. And it is celebrated across the world on 20th of December. And this is celebrated to raise the public awareness of the importance of solidarity and to remind the government to respect their commitments to the international agreements and to encourage the new initiative for poverty eradication. Now the next question. DAS has won the Sahitya Academy Award in non-fiction category of An Era of Darkness and it is written in English language. And the answer here is, it's Shashi Tharoor. So Shashi Tharoor has been awarded with the Sahitya Academy for An Era of Darkness that is written in English language. And if you look at the other option, the second option is given Nandakishore Acharya. And he has been awarded with the Sahitya Academy Award in poetry category for Chillate Hue Apne Ko in Hindi language. And the third option is given Penna Madhusudan and he has won the Sahitya Academy Award in poetry category again for the poem written in Sanskrit language. And the next option is given Safiq Kidwai, and he has been awarded for the Urdu biography. And the last option is given Joyce Goswami Mahant, and she has been awarded for the Chanakya novel that is written in Assamese language. Now the next question, who has been appointed as the Lokayukta of Telangana? And the answer here is, it's C.V. Ramulu. So he is the former High Court Judge, Justice C.V. Ramulu, who has been appointed as the Lokayukta of Telangana. And apart from him, if you look at the other option, it's given V. Niranjan Rao, he has been appointed as Upa Lokayukta. And G. Chandraya, he has been appointed as the chairman of the State Human Rights Commission. Now the next question, who among the following Indian weightlifter won the women's 49kg category gold medal at the 6th Qatar International Cup held in Doha? And the answer here is, it's Mirabai Chanu. So what's the capital of Qatar? It's Doha, and currency is Qatari Riyal. Which country has been crowned FIFA Team of the Year for the second successive time? And the answer here is, it's Belgium. And who is the president of FIFA? It's Gianni Infantino, and it was founded in the year 1904, and headquarters is located in Zurich. Now the next question, Google searches for Dash surged in India after the central bank announced its version of the US Federal Reserve's unconventional monetary policy. And the answer here is, it's Operation Twist. Now the next question, which of the following international organization recently extended its partnership with the International Cricket Council for Women's T20 World Cup 2020 with a focus on empowering women and girls through cricket? And the answer here is, it's UNICEF. So who is the CEO of ICC, that is International Cricket Council? It's Manu Sahani. And who is the ICC chairman? Shashank Manohar Parikh. Now the next question here. So who is the chairman? It's Shashank Manohar. And where is the headquarter located? It is in Dubai. Now the next question. Who among the following Indian-American computer scientist will lead the prestigious National Science Foundation in the USA? And the answer here is, it's Sethuraman Panchanathan. Now the next question, which day was observed every year as the National Mathematics Day? And the answer here is, it is on 22nd of December. And this is observed on behalf of the birth anniversary of the mathematician Srinivasan Ramanujan. And this is the 132nd birth anniversary of Srinivasan Ramanujan. Now the next question here, who has been appointed as the Prime Minister of Cuba after 40 years? And the answer here is, it's Manuel Marrero Cruz. And who is the President of Cuba? It's Miguel Díaz-Canel, he is the President. What is the capital of Cuba? It's Havana. And currency is Cuban peso. Who among the following has been appointed as the first woman chief technology officer at the US government's powerful Federal Communication Commission? And the answer here is, it's Monisha Ghosh. So she will be taking charge on 13th of January, replacing Eric Berger, who honored with the Silver Jubilee International Conference of Art in Dhaka by Bangladesh. And the answer is R. Nagaswamy. So he is an archaeologist who honored with the Silver Jubilee International Conference of Art in Bangladesh. He is an Indian historian, archaeologist and epigraphist. Now the next question. Aditya K, honored with the Bharat Award for bravery, belongs to which state of India? And he belongs to Kerala. Who is the Chief Minister of Kerala? Is P. Vijayan. Governor is Arif Mohammed Khan. And where is the capital? It is in Thiruvananthapuram. Who among the following were named for the International Tennis Federation World Champions in Women's Singles for 2019? And the answer here is Ashleigh Barty. Now the next question. Who among the following were named for the International Tennis Federation's World Champions in Men's Single for 2019? And this has been given to Rafael Nadal. So with these two awards, has been given to Ashleigh Barty and Rafael Nadal, were named as the International Tennis Federation World Championship in Singles for 2019. And where is the headquarters of this International Tennis Federation? It is in London. And who is the president of ITF, that is International Tennis Federation? It's David Haggerty. He is the president of ITF.
Hello everyone, welcome to TalentSprint. Today we are here to discuss the last week of December current affairs. So let's start with the discussion part. Here is the first question on your screen. Which of the following states launched the Nithanan Istam scheme to provide the financial assistance to handloom weavers across the state? And the answer here is, it's Andhra Pradesh. So who is the Chief Minister of Andhra Pradesh? It's Y.S. Jagmohan Reddy. So he has launched this YSR Nithanan Istam scheme at Dharmavaram in Anandpur district to provide the financial assistance of 24,000 annually. So who is the governor of Andhra Pradesh? It's Biswabhushan Harichandan. Now the next question. Who among the following has been appointed as the president of the Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry? And the answer here is, it's Sangeeta Reddy. So Sangeeta Reddy, who is the joint managing director of Apollo Hospital Group, has taken over as the president of the Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry for 2019-20, succeeding Sandeep Somani. So what does this FICCI stands for? We have written here, this is Federation of Indian Chamber of Commerce and Industry, and this was established in the year 1927. And headquarters is located in New Delhi. Now the next question, who has been appointed as the new Foreign Secretary of India? And the answer here is so Harshvardhan Singla is the senior diplomat, India's ambassador to US, and he has been appointed as the new Foreign Secretary, and he will take over charge of the Foreign Secretary on 29th of January, succeeding Vijay Gokhale. According to the latest US report, DAS has emerged as the world's third largest publisher of science and engineering articles. And the answer is, it's India. So India has emerged as the world's third largest publisher of science and engineering articles, whereas China is in the first position and the US at the second position. Now the next question, which of the following railway station of Indian Railways has opened oxygen parlor to battle the rising air pollution in cities? And the answer here is, it's Nasik Railway Station. So this is an unique initiative to battle the rising air pollution in the cities with an oxygen parlor. This has been opened in this railway station. Now the next question, Who among the following was the author of the book Ma Siddheshwari, who passed away recently? And the answer here is Vidushi Savita Devi. So she is a Hindustani classical vocalist who passed away. She was the author of this book, Ma Siddheshwari, which was the biography of her mother, Siddheshwari Devi. And if you look at the second option, it's given Martin Peters, who scored England's second goal in 1966 World Cup final against West Germany. He passed away. And the third option is given Ganga Prasad Vimal. He was a renowned Hindi author whose last novel was Manuskar. And the fourth option is given here, Ali Willis, who passed away recently. She was an American songwriter and she penned the iconic track that is named as I Will Be There For You, which was a long-running television show in France. And the last option is given, that's it. He was China's brilliant storyteller and author of the book Colors of the Mountain. Now the next question. So which among the following banks signed a memorandum of understanding with Gujarat government to facilitate the flow of credit in the micro, small and medium enterprises sector? And the answer here is it's Bank of Baroda. According to this agreement, the credit will be provided to the MSME for greenfield projects, startups and women entrepreneurs from backward areas. So where is the headquarter of Bank of Baroda? It is in Vadodara. Who is the MD and CEO? It's P.S. Jay Kumar. And what's the tagline of this bank? It's India's international bank. Now the next question. Who among the following has taken oath as the chief minister of Jharkhand? So the answer here is it's Hemant Soren. And who is the governor of Jharkhand? It's Draupadi Murmu. Who among the following will replace Danny Smillenberg as the CEO of Boeing with effect from the 13th January 2020? And the answer here is David Calhoun. So David Calhoun will replace Danny Smillenberg as the CEO of Boeing with effect from 13th of January. So where is the headquarter of Boeing located? It is in Chicago of US. Now the next question. Which state has topped the Good Governance Index among the big states launched by central government on the occasion of Good Governance Day? And the answer here is, it's Tamil Nadu. So Tamil Nadu has topped this Good Governance Index among the big states launched by the central government on the occasion of Good Governance Day, whereas Puducherry has topped the Good Governance Index among the Union Territories. And Himachal Pradesh has topped the Good Governance Index among the Northeast and Hilly States. So who among the following has taken over as the new president of the Associated Chambers of Commerce and Industry of India? And the answer here is Niranjan Hidanandani. So he has taken over as the new president of ASSOCHAM. So what is the full form of ASSOCHAM? It's Associated Chamber of Commerce and Industry of India. Now the next question. DAS scheme recently launched by the Prime Minister Narendra Modi aims to improve the groundwater management. And the answer here is it's Atal Bhujan Yojana. So the government has outlaid around 6,000 crore for this scheme out of the total outlay of 6,000 crore to be implemented over 5 years, that is from 2022-2025, whereas the 50% shall be in the form of World Bank loan and to be repaid by the central government. Now the next question, which cricketer has been named as the captain of Cricket Australia's ODI team of the decade? And the answer here is, it's Mahendra Singh Dhoni. So he has been named as the captain of the Cricket Australia's, that is ODI team of the decade. Now the next question here, which bank has tied up with the Pine Labs to enable the debit card facilities for the debit card holders across point of sale terminals by Pine Labs? And the answer here is Kotak Mahindra Bank. So Kotak Mahindra Bank has tied up with the Pine Labs to enable the debit card facilities for the card holders. The bank customers can avail these EMI facilities with a minimum purchase of 8,000, which can be repaid over 3 months to 12 months. So Kotak Mahindra Bank was established in the year 2003. And where is the headquarter? It is in Mumbai of Maharashtra. So who is the MD and CEO? It's Uday Kotak. He is the MD and CEO of this bank. And what is the tagline? Let's make money simple. So the tagline here is, this is the tagline of Kotak Mahindra Bank. Now the next question, which bank has tied up with online real estate platform Magic Bricks for listing and e-auctioning of immovable properties repossessed by it in recovery proceedings? And the answer here is, it's Federal Bank. So Federal Bank has tied up with online real estate platform Magic Bricks, and Federal Bank was established in the year 1939, named it as Travancore Federal Bank, and in 1949 it became Federal Bank. So where is the headquarter? Headquarter is located in Kochi. And who is the MD and CEO? Is Shyam Srinivasan. He is the MD and CEO of Federal Bank. And what is the tagline? Your perfect banking partner. Now the next question, which organization has announced a loan of $210 million for irrigation and solar energy project in India? And the answer here is Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank. So the bank will lend $145 million to improve the irrigation service and to strengthen the flood risk management in West Bengal. And the bank will also lend another $65 million for 250 megawatt solar project in Rajasthan. So this irrigation project in West Bengal is co-financed by the World Bank, and it is expected to strengthen the management of Damodar Valley Command Area Irrigation Scheme. So who is the president of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank? It's Jin Liquin. And headquarters is in Beijing of China. Now the next question. The Reserve Bank of India has capped the permissible exposure limit of a lender on a peer-to-peer lending platform for all borrowers at TAS. And the answer here is, it's 50 lakhs rupees. So who was conferred with the American Academy of Ophthalmology Highest Award Life Achievement Honor? And the answer here is Dr. Santosh G. Hunawar. So he was conferred with American Academy of Ophthalmology, and this was founded in the year 1979, and headquarters is located in San Francisco of California. Now the next question. The Reserve Bank of India has directed the large cooperative banks to report all exposures of DAS and more to the Central Repository of Information on Large Credits. And the answer here is, it's rupees 5 crore. Which country has developed its first avant-garde hypersonic missile system with the latest strategic missiles of intercontinental range? And the answer here is, it's Russia. So Russia has deployed its first avant-garde hypersonic missile system with the latest strategic missiles of intercontinental range. The avant-garde can carry a nuclear weapon of up to 2 megatons. So who is the president of Russia? It's Vladimir Putin. What's the capital? It's Moscow. And currency is Russian ruble. Now the next question, Which country has successfully launched its largest carrier rocket, Long March 5? And the answer here is, it's China. So what's the capital of China? It's Beijing. Currency is Renminbi. And this rocket is also known as CZ-5. Now the next question, which insurance firm has partnered with Paytm to expand its distribution by the enabling customers of Paytm to purchase its insurance products? And the answer here is, it's HDFC Life Insurance. So this has partnered with Paytm to expand its distribution. So who is the founder of Paytm? It's Vijay Sekhar Sharma, and it was founded in the year 2010. Now the next question. So who has created a record for the longest single space flight by surpassing the record of 288 days in space by NASA astronaut Peggy Whitson in 2017? And the answer here is, it's Christina Coates. So she is NASA astronaut who has created a record for the longest single space flight by a woman. So where is the headquarters of NASA located? It is in Washington, D.C. And it was established in the year 1958. Name the two Indian cricketers who featured in the Wisden's T20 International Team of the Decade released recently. And the answer here is, it's Virat Kohli and Jasprit Bumrah. So these are the two Indian cricketers who has been named in Wisden's T20 International Team of the Decade list. So who is the Chief Executive Officer of ICC? It's Manu Sahani. Where is the headquarters? It is located in Dubai of UAE. Now the next question. Which bank is going to introduce one-time password-based ATM cash withdrawals which has been effected from January 1st of 2020? And the answer here is, it's State Bank of India. So State Bank of India has introduced this OTP system where in every cash withdrawal of rupees 10,000 and above between morning 8 a.m. to 8 p.m. you'll have to access this OTP. Now the next question, who became the Indian Grandmaster on the world's Women Rapid Chess Championship held in Moscow of Russia? And the answer here is, it's Koneru Hampi. Who becomes the Chief of Defense Staff succeeding General Bipin Rawat, who retired on 31st December of 2019? And the answer here is, it's Manoj Mukund Naravne. Now the next question, which day was observed as Kisan Divas or National Farmers Day? And the answer here is, it's 23rd December. So the National Farmers Day honors Chaudhary Ranjan Singh, who was the fifth Prime Minister of India, who was born on this particular day. Now the next question, which day is observed as National Consumer Day every year? And it is observed on 24th of December. And the theme of this year is Alternate Consumer Grievances or Dispute Redressal. The World Consumer Rights Day is observed on 15th of March. This is World Consumer Day. And 24th December is National Consumer Day. And what was the theme of it? This Alternate Consumer Grievances or Dispute Redressal. Now the next question. India celebrates the birth anniversary of Bharat Ratna and former Prime Minister Atal Bihari Vajpayee as Good Governance Day on DAS. And the answer here is, it's 25th of December.
And with this question, we have done for the December month current affairs. We covered all the important bits from the month of December. And this question I have chosen from the weekly current affairs. I have already told you, if time permits and if you want to go through more MCQs, then refer the weekly current affairs video. And where for each week, we have around 40 to 50 questions at least. So all in total, you'll have around 200 MCQs from the weekly current affairs. So That's all for the day. Keep practicing, keep reading, and stay tuned. Thank you.